Hi, today we will have a look at this little buttons panel from an aircraft cockpit, new stock. But first, I have to apologize for the lack of videos recently. In fact, there are several reasons. The main one is that after almost more than 1,000 videos, I am running out of stuff to show. I still have a few things, but some of them are big and will require quite some time to do the videos. And apart from this, the other things are not worth showing, always the same kind of aircraft instruments or things like this. So I am a little annoyed, now I have to find more stuff, in fact. Hope I will find stuff in flea markets. So I am quite busy at this time, and I am preparing a travel to West Indies in a few days. So it is why I was not able to do too many videos. So for today, we have this new old stock aircraft buttons panel. It is actually in my top 5 most modern aircraft parts because it is made in 2005. It seems to be a buttons panel for the onboard systems management or fault management computer on an airliner. We have backlit buttons with status lights. This one is obviously clear, probably for clearing the faults condition or something like this. Store and recall, I guess. We have engine, hydraulics, AC and DC power bus. Bleed must be something for the related to the engines. Conditioner, maybe the air conditioner. Pressure, fuel, wheel, door, flight control and auxiliary power unit. So there are little clicky buttons. You can see here around we have 8 screws. Here is what it looks on the side. So it is probably obviously something made to plug into a larger module because you can see the cutouts here for those fasteners on the main computer module in the cockpit. Here is what it looks like on the rear. So we have this big plug with 3 row of pins, screws. And here is the manufacturer plate, made in France, so it is obviously for an Airbus aircraft. SECME Coopération Aérospatiale, here is the serial model and serial numbers, and the date code of 2005. So everything seems to be made of aluminium. This is made from with aluminium. This also, this also, this also. So it seems to be very expensive, very well made, quite heavy in fact for a little part like this. Oddly enough, if I find my scale, we will weigh the thing. In fact, it is not light, which is quite surprising. Yes, 245 grams. Okay, so obviously we have screws at the back, which should allow to see the inside. So I will remove them now and I will be right back. So all the screws are off. First, about this connector, you can see it seems this metal plate here on this kind of standoff are actually prisoner between the connector and the circuit board because of the wires. The connector is mounted on this side, and even if I undo these screws, it looks like I will not be able to remove completely these parts. It is quite a shame. You can see the thickness of the thing here, the two millimeters, maybe three for this one. Really, really impressive. I did remove the other screws here and also three screws here at the bottom between the wires. And now I can, I guess, lift. Yes, I can, because in fact I did already do it previously. Lift the wall internals, but it is a very tight fit and it is not really easy. Here we are, and here we are. So, the front piece with the buttons which are still attached. I did put some captain tape in order to avoid losing all the buttons in case they were coming loose, but it is not happening because it seems they are sandwiched between these two parts, actually this one and this. So this front piece comes off probably with these 8 screws, but they are tiny torque set heads and I haven't got this matching screwdriver, so I will not remove them, and also to avoid any scratch or damage. So it seems we have a plastic plate here with a number of screws, and actually this piece here is attached with the these screws in the front. Okay, and yes, the keys are somewhat prisoner between these two pieces, it seems. So you can see there is a light guide here for the status light, and a white diffuser for the background light, standby light of the key. Interesting. So about this main part. Here is what it looks like. Oops. We have this. All these little parts did come off. They are pushers, I guess. Yes. In fact, they will actually translate the movement of the key to the actual contacts, which are these little domes, just like in calculators. I was expecting something more sophisticated, in fact, but no. We have a pretty thick circuit board with the set of bulbs for either the backlight and the activity light of the switches. Overside, nothing except tracks, some insulator, or the manufacturer writing here, dead code of 2005. Here is the backing metal plate, and in fact, it is all, except for this. Here we have one more piece, so it is a light diffusing piece, it seems. Mounted on this kind of very thick fiber material. And you can see just for this we already have 5 screws to keep these two parts together. And this little metal, ah yes, these are what provide the apparently the spring action on the buttons. We have these little metal rods which are spring loaded. There is a little spring behind each one of them. So I guess if I take this apart, all the spring will fly off. So it will probably not be a good idea to do so. But you can see the number of parts in this thing is quite insane. It is quite weird they did use some kind of ship way to make the contacts. Quite amazing, in fact, because everything else is very well made. Also, it looks like it should not be really easy to replace these little bulbs because there are some kind of riveted in the... Oh, no. It is little sockets. So, it with golden legs on the bulbs. You do not see it every day. So yes, it is possible to replace them a lot of work, obviously, but it is doable. I would like to maybe try to power them on, see what they do. I have no idea of the voltage they will require, so I will start low. I need to find a way to grab these things. It will probably not be easy because the contacts are very small. Or maybe I can fall over. Tracks on the PCB. It looks like there is one here. No, it will not. So I will try like so. Yes, it is very faintly. I will increase the voltage. Oh, here we are. Maybe it is even a little too much. I am at 5 volts now. And yes, everything is lighting up. But these ones, I guess, yes, they will light up 2 at a time for the status of the buttons. So interesting, and you can see these ones are in a white diffuser glass, while these ones are in a clear glass. So quite nice actually, very expensive part for sure. Okay, now I will try to put all this back together. So thanks for watching, bye bye.